Today I'm going to show you how to change your water pump. Chevy Malibu. So first you want to go ahead and remove the heat shield, which is going to be three little small bolts on it, alright? One there, one there, another one there, alright? So it's going to be 10 millimeter right here. So you want to go ahead and remove this 10 millimeter right here too, alright? Get a 10 millimeter wrench and it will work fine right here. Alright. Alright, so you want to come right here with a flathead screwdriver. If you don't have one of this one, take this off. It might break like that one, but it's okay. You can use a tight strap and strap it back when it's time to go back in, alright? So now you want to go ahead and unplug this. So you want to push this back, push down on it, alright? I need my tool in for that. So now the heat shield is off, you want to go ahead and remove these two 10 millimeter right here. Alright, go ahead and remove these two 10 millimeter right here, alright? And also remove the hose, you can go ahead and remove the hose now. Second one there, just want to remove them, and this is what I use to remove them, 10 millimeter wrench. All right, I removed those two right here. Now you can go ahead and lift this up right here. Now it's free to move. All right, you can see me moving it. That disconnect the belt. It don't matter when you disconnect the belt, but you're gonna have to disconnect the belt. You want to take out this one right here. I don't know if you can see it under that one right there, and another one right in the back over there, and one more underneath. So there's three bolts that's holding the water pump to the engine block. All right. Get some light down there. So I'll already go ahead and remove the hose. So now it's time to get this back here, and it's gonna be 13 millimeter, and the other one that's back there. I'm gonna try zooming on it. That one right there. Also gonna be 13 millimeter to take out. All right. Use my tool in here, and also. Also, you're gonna need to remove this right here, this wire. Alright, so now that's free. That's good. Take out 13 time for me to take out the belt right here. As you can see, that's what I have. I have a ratchet under on it. I'm gonna take it off, alright? That's how you take the pump up, alright? The reason being the pump is bad because it's bearing the one bad in the pump, so it was leaking through right here. It was leaking through the bearing in the pump, alright? Old pump, alright? So you have one 13mm right there and one right here. I'll put up. I remember I could have only show you the two top ones, but the bottom one is right here, alright? So that's all you need to take. That's all holding it. One, two, three, holding it, alright? Any question you have, you can leave it in the comment and I'll try my best to answer it as soon as possible, alright? Alright, so now I got the new pump, so I'm gonna put it in. Here's the new pump, and it comes with the screws in it. With the bolts in it, so 1, 2, 3, that's what hold it to the body of the car, and you have a O-ring right here, should see, and that's it. I'm gonna put it on. All right same way you take it out, same way you put it on. All right you catch the pump up, you might want to go ahead and lift this hose up, alright? Lift it above the pump, so let it stay above the pump at all times, alright? Now it's time to tighten it up, alright? So now it's time to I put the 10mm, I'm gonna need to get this washer right here, because the pump didn't come with it. So when you're ordering it from the dealer, make sure you get a washer with it. This washer, the first washer, alright? And I'm gonna put the belt in the meantime.
After I tighten up the
those two 10mm. Now it's time to put the heat shield on. So now you want to go ahead and connect your oxygen sensor. Probably gonna need my tool hand to connect it right here. I got it. Secure it. And what we'll do is put it back in here. Alright. That you double check your work, make sure everything is nice and tight up in there, the belt's on. Go ahead and add coolant in it and let it run for some minutes and add coolant again, alright? And that's why you change your water pump on 2014 and 15 and 13 Chevy Malibu.